What's up, everybody? I'm Matt Gary, and in this episode of Coding with the Fours, we're going to go over what design patterns are, when to use them, and why you'd want to use them, even in the world of Salesforce. All right, guys. So today, in this first episode of this design patterns tutorial series that I am putting together, we are gonna be talking about what design patterns actually are, when you might use them, why you might use them, the design patterns you should actually consider learning, because there are tons of them out there, and when you should start to consider learning about design patterns in general, because I do think there is a certain point in your career that you should consider them, and you should not start thinking about them too much until you get to that point. But before we get into what design patterns are and all the rest of that good stuff, make sure if you actually enjoy this video to like it, because when you do, it helps this video get out to more people just like you that want to learn about this stuff for free. So enjoy the video, like it. Now let's get back to design patterns. So let's get to it. The first thing I want to go over is that last point. When should you even think about design patterns? In my opinion, you shouldn't start with design patterns when you're starting off in the world of code. And I say that because I think it deters people. I think it's confusing when you're first starting to write code in any language to start with design patterns, because then you think all of your code has to like conform to a design pattern and et cetera, et cetera. And quite frankly, all of your code won't conform to a design pattern. You won't use design patterns for everything that you develop. And it will only serve to confuse you and potentially cause you to over-engineer your code in ways that you don't want it to. So I would first just learn the basic building blocks of code, how it works, maybe build a couple applications on your own without knowing anything about design patterns. And then once you've built some things and you've identified the pain points that you can get yourself into, come back to design patterns and it will help you learn about how to deal with those situations that you might find yourself in your code that are tricky or difficult or causing problems with performance or whatever else. So I'd say wait a little bit. The second thing is, once you get comfortable with code in general, I would learn about design principles before I got into design patterns. And the reason I say that is because the principles kind of guide the patterns anyway. So if you understand the underlying design principles, then the patterns that we will talk about will make a lot more sense. So for instance, if you don't know what design principles are, I did a whole tutorial series over the solid design principles a while back. I'd go, if you're already comfortable with code, and watch the solid design principles tutorial series that I put together, because that'll help you understand a lot of the underlying ideas for the design patterns that we'll go over. You could also just read a book like Clean Code by Robert Martin or Uncle Bob. And that's got some excellent stuff about design principles in it as well. So before you get into design patterns, just get comfortable with code and get comfortable with design principles. Cool. Now that we've got that out of the way, let's figure out what design patterns actually are. So first things first, design patterns are basically exactly what they say they are. They are patterns designed to help you out of tricky situations that you'll find yourself in when you're coding, right? So, and they're more than that too, right? They're not only these patterns that you can use to get out of things, but they're patterns that you can use that are also built to allow your code to be flexible, easy to read or, deal with. and to be more performant when you're done writing it. So these can really, really, really come in handy. Maybe you've written something and it's constantly taking 2 or 3 minutes to load. Well, maybe if you used a singleton to only load, load something that was really time consuming one time, you could cut down on the time in which, you know, you were having your page load, right? So these design patterns are exactly what they say they are. They're just ways to help you out of a situation. They're patterns that have been built or designed to help you out of difficult coding situations. So each pattern that we go over in this series, I will tell you, this is a pattern that is prescribed for these types of situations you might find yourself in. And if you're still confused by that, let me make it like really, really easy. If you have a headache, you'll go to the doctor. And the doctor will, in all likelihood, most of the time anyway, prescribe you something like Tylenol, Advil, or ibuprofen to get out of your headache situation. And any three of those will work most of the time. 90% of the time, you'll get out of your headache and you'll feel fine afterwards. 10% of the time, it won't work. That's the same kind of situation with design patterns. We've got things that are prescribed, design patterns that are prescribed for situations. 90% of the time, they work. 10% of the time, maybe it was the wrong call. Maybe something else could have done a better job. Okay, so we've kind of gone over what they are, when you should learn, what design patterns are, you know, when you would use them, why they're useful, when you should learn design patterns. The next thing that we should go over are the design patterns that you should actually kind of focus on learning, because there are tons, and I mean tons, of design patterns in existence. But there are 23 that you should learn, I think, before any of the others, because they are the most widely used and the most highly regarded, I would say. And those are the design patterns that are described as the Gang of Four design patterns, which is extremely confusing, in my opinion. These 23 design patterns were made by four people who go by the Gang of Four, and they wrote a book together about them, right? So four authors described as the Gang of Four wrote a book about 23 design principles that fall into three categories: behavioral design patterns, creational design patterns, and structural design patterns. And those 23 patterns are the ones that I would focus my energy on, because those are the ones that you've probably heard about in the first place. Things like the singleton pattern, or the observer pattern, or the template method pattern. These are the big ones that people are going to ask you questions about, that you're going to see in most code bases, etc., etc. And they're very useful. I mean, they've held up for almost 30 years now. So, yeah, at least since the book came out. I think it was in 1995 that book was written. It's been a while. Anyway, so that's what we're going to go over in this series. We're going to go over all 23 of those design patterns and how you can implement them in your code base. We will also be going over some basic areas of object-oriented programming, because I just want to cover them just in case you're not super familiar with them. So we are going to go over what object-oriented programming is, what inheritance is, encapsulation, and polymorphism. So, yeah. I think that's probably enough for this video. I hope that you kind of understand now a little bit more about what design patterns are, and what their purpose is, when you should learn about them, and which ones you should focus on. I'll put a link in the description below to the Gang of Four's design pattern book that they wrote long ago. If you're a Salesforce developer, I don't know if I say his name right, but Jitinder Zha and one other person I am forgetting the name of, so sorry, wrote a book about design patterns in Apex, and I'll link that below too, so you can check it out if you want to. And in the next episode of this tutorial series, we are going to be going over object-oriented topics. So we'll get through all of that stuff, and then we'll get down into each of those design patterns in the Gang of Four. So I hope this has been helpful, and I hope I see you in the next video. See you later.